What's up, everybody?
Welcome to CES 2025.
This is crazy. So Justin and I are back here, back to back, hosting the entire show. And we are in this creator space that you will be able to check out yourselves later. But we haven't really set up yet, right? The whole show is still going on, right?
There's still construction happening. People are all around setting up. And it's really kind of fun to see sort of this behind the scenes look right before it all opens.
So all the beep, beep, boop, boops. Hey, we're doing it live, as I say, but you're seeing it a little later. Now, we want to bring us a special guest here, Brian Comiskey. He's the Senior Director of Innovation and Tech Trends with CTA, which is the group that is putting on CES. We also like to call him the futurist. Is that right? You see the future?
I do my best to. I really just live at the intersection of what if and why not.
So, Brian, you know, we're here. We've been here at CES 2024. There are a lot of big tech trends that happen. What are some of those trends that maybe are still carrying out through to 2025 still today?
Well, certainly we should start with artificial intelligence. It was a major presence at last year's show, and it will be again this year. It's about how do you build from the excitement of generative AI into a variety of other applications across the show floor for AI. In addition, that we'll see advancements in digital health, energy, and of course, the mobility show.
And something that I'm so excited about is digital health, because I've been doing a lot of sort of, you know, just biohacking and personal experiments on myself. So I'm like, oh, we're here at CES. What is there that I should maybe like try to check out? Like, what's the trends in digital health right now?
Right now, I would describe it as longevity, and it sounds very futurist, sci-fi, but all it really means is longer living, healthier living, and better living. So how is smart home, digital health, biotechnology, mental health technology all converging together to really offer those things, allow us to live longer and better?
Oh, yeah, I mean, I can't wait.
That is specifically more featured in the Venetian area of the show, is that correct?
Yes, this year actually, it really makes sense on trend where smart home and digital health are gonna be together for the first time, really showcasing how smart home devices are increasingly about health and vice versa.
Big business happens here at CES, and that means enterprise is a lot of stuff happening behind the scenes here. So tell us what's going on at CES this year.
Of course, and that's why it's CES at the end of the day, because we have as much enterprise going on as well as consumer. And it really starts with AI again. It's about how do you get more productivity out of chatbots, out of different features that you can bring into your enterprise, but also cybersecurity, cloud computing, financial tech software. Really, how does the business of tomorrow get smarter and more accessible and just more easy to use?
Okay, something else, mobility and transportation. So I know I saw Rivian the first time years and years ago, and now we both are Rivian owners. ES has now become such a massive car show. And we were even like riding in like a little helicopter thing last year. Like it was wild. So what are we gonna be seeing this year?
Well, you're gonna see the entire mobility ecosystem. It starts with those fun vehicles. Scout Motors will be here showcasing their electric vehicles. You'll see it in boats and flying vehicles as well. And it's also about what's on board those vehicles. So we're talking about advanced infotainment systems, AI digital voice assistants that replace driver's manuals, because those things are huge now and I can't thumb through them fast. And of course, it's about going big with mobility. And by that, I mean industrial vehicles. So we'll have Oshkosh, Deer, Caterpillar, and more, showcasing the next level of mining, agricultural, and construction applications.
I think also we spend a lot of time in our cars, and these are really becoming infotainment entertainment systems. And so seeing how that space has evolved, I think of a car like the Sony Afila, which is like Qualcomm, and Microsoft Cloud, and Sony and Honda working together. Those are brands that you feel like those exist at CES, and had to be some part of the birthplace of how that started, right?
Well, I wouldn't call them even cars or boats anymore. They're really software-defined vehicles, because there's so much on board them now that allows for just, it's about personalization at the end of the day. That's why we keep saying AI, we keep talking about more features on board. It's how does technology feel like a platform for an individual's experience rather than just a device or a vehicle that you step into or use?
And even just like self-driving. I mean, even like Waymo is basically taking over Los Angeles. So it's like things like that in that vein of just being able to have those driverless cars be the now.
Yeah, well, I mean, the future is already here in that one. It's just only some cities are starting to experience what Waymo has to offer. And so I actually think that was the most underappreciated trend in 2024 was self-driving vehicles, because we hit 100,000 drivers a week at Waymo, and you'll see that start to really build out this year. So autonomy is a major area to watch on the enterprise side and the consumer side.
You know, also entertainment and culture. A lot of people may not initially think that. We've been at CES for years. We've seen booths from like TV networks. What is happening behind the scenes here? Because we see a lot of like IP and brands. How are they kind of weaving themselves into this whole tech space?
Of course, and at CES, you really see that across all the campuses of our show. On the hardware side in Central Hall, the Las Vegas Convention Center, you're gonna see a lot of the brand new TVs, audio equipment that really is helping power a lot of the entertainment and culture we love. And then of course the C-Space campus, which is one of my favorite areas to go to, is about that IP, the branding, the advertising. Because at the end of the day, what content and entertainment really are, it's a platform for self-expression and our culture. So sometimes I think about what does the C stand for in C-Space? I look at it as culture.
And now moving on to something that, you know, I wish that I could explain more about, quantum tech. There's so much that goes into this, and I feel like even sometimes when I'm trying to research it, it's just, there's so much information, and I feel like CES is definitely the place to see that future of quantum tech.
Yeah, and I'll be clear, I'm a futurist, not a quantum physicist, but what quantum computing, from every research that I've seen and done, it's really about speed and precision. This idea of how can computers more quickly be able to discern data at a rapid scale? How can sensors be more precise to give us readings on our wearables or industrial applications? So really at the show this year, you're gonna see a lot more of quantum, including a new half-day track from Quantum World Congress. And you'll see some exhibitors showcasing really the next stage of computing, cyber, and the enterprise.
So I guess for you, like, because you've been here for so long and you've seen so many things, like, what are you most excited about?
I'm excited about another new conference track and category, which is energy transition. And this is really relevant now, especially with the AI story. It takes a lot of power for data centers to give us a lot of the content and entertainment and the apps that we all enjoy, right? And so how do we make sure that we continue to power them, but also sustainably? So we'll see companies really talk about how are we getting energy in new ways, whether that's nuclear. There's actually a startup from France showcasing modular nuclear reactors. I'm sure it's gonna be more of a tabletop booth instead of a reactor, but still, we're talking about the future of energy, which my background prior to this was in energy, so I get really excited about that.
Oh, wow. Jay, any other categories that you're excited about for here at CES?
I mean, obviously as creators, there's no creator space. Even just running around, like, we get to meet people that, you know, that watch our videos and content. So it's like, that's actually also kind of a really fun part of it, but the digital health stuff is something I've been doing a ton of research on, so I can't wait to see what the future is.
That's awesome. And what about you, Brian?
I have transportation mobility. I think that has been a space that has just been more and more fascinating, whether it's like flying like personal vehicles now, and then the evolution of the cockpit. A lot of crazy stuff happening. So it's we've seen self-driving, but now like almost like living in our cars more than just driving them. I feel like that we're moving in that direction.
I need like a little microwave oven because I'm always eating in my car. So I'd like a little like toaster oven or something to like, you know, heat up my.
These are electrically powered vehicles now. So I think that's totally doable.
Yeah, maybe like a little air fryer for the Rivian.
I mean, there's a lot more connectivity.
Food tech.
We can't forget about that.
So they have like food samples in that area.
We need to find that.
I believe it's Venetian based as well.
Venetian campus. You'll find robots that can help prepare meals for you. You'll find AI chef assistants to give you new ideas for cooking. And beyond that, like, I know, it's like the cook's dream over there.
This all sounds so great. I can't believe it. Like, it's finally almost time.
It's time for CES. And remember, for all of you watching right now, you can follow CES on all the different social channels, all the hashtags. Let's see, Justin and I will have videos on our channels. You can also obviously follow CES's channel. What are you gonna be doing, B?
I'm gonna be walking the show floor, looking at enterprise technology, other innovations, and you can follow me on my social channels as well, on X and LinkedIn, and really be a part of that conversation with the hashtag CES2025.
Awesome.
All right.
I can't wait.
I can't wait either.
We'll see you guys there.
See y'all.
Bye.